The Bible says in Mark chapter 1, verse 4, John did baptize in the wilderness and preached the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins. The Bible says very clearly here that John the Baptist preached the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins. I want to make a quick video exposing this guy by the name of Charles Lawson.
What's happening? What's changing? You want me to tell you what's changing? They took the word what out? Repent. They took repent out. The Bible colleges around the country will stand at the judgment seat of Christ and give an account for removing repentance from salvation and conversion.
Now, Mr. Lawson uses a tactic that is extremely prevalent amongst many false prophets. They'll make claims and accusations against men that believe salvation is by faith alone. You don't have to turn from your sins to be saved. You don't have to follow Christ to be saved. You don't have to obey the commandments to be saved. No, you have to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, as the Bible so plainly teaches. Well, they'll throw accusations out there and they'll make claims like this. Well, you believe someone doesn't have to repent to be saved. Or you're removing repentance from salvation. Well, that's simply not true, and that's an illegitimate argument. I do believe someone has to repent to be saved. The difference between me and Charles Lawson is I don't believe someone has to repent of their sins to be saved, because that's a works-based salvation, and that makes Charles Lawson a wicked false prophet.
How can you be saved if you're not willing to repent? Salvation is not believing a bunch of stuff about Christ. You can change your mind about what you believe about him. And you can, where you say before, I don't believe all this. Now you say, I believe all this. Does that make you born again? For the heart, man believeth for righteousness. But you see, you can get a lot of people into church with easy believism. 1, 2, 3, believe after me. You prayed the sinner's prayer. You can fill up the congregation and then go brag to the brethren about what a great job God's doing through you. Of course, all that great job, what God's doing through you, is meaningless. What they really mean to say is, look how wonderful I am. That's the idea. But they took repentance out.
The Bible clearly defines what the baptism of repentance is. In Acts chapter 19, verse 4, the Bible reads, then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is, on Christ Jesus. So according to Acts chapter 19, verse 4, from Paul's own mouth, what was John preaching when he was preaching the baptism of repentance? Well, the verse clearly says that he was saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is, on Christ Jesus. So according to the Bible, when we preach repentance, what are we preaching? That people should believe on Christ. You see, repent means to turn or to change. And in context of salvation, what needs to change? Is it the way we dress? Is it the way we look? Is it the way we act or the way we speak? What do we need to turn from? Well, all that has to change about an individual in order for them to be saved is what they believe. Because believing is what determines where you will spend eternity. If you believe on Christ, you're not condemned. If you don't believe on Christ, you are condemned already, the Bible says. So all that we have to turn from is not believing on Christ to believing on Christ. All that has to change is what we believe. We have to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. That is repentance, changing what you believe, turning from unbelief to belief on the Lord Jesus Christ. So Mr. Lawson clearly does not know the definition of repentance when it comes to salvation. Why? Because he's not saved. He preaches another Jesus and another gospel, and we should mark him and avoid him.